Fujifilm just announced its new camera line with the new Fujifilm XS10. From what I've seen, it looks to be a very capable photography camera with really good video production capabilities. Now, timing-wise, this announcement could not have been any better for me. Ish. I was thinking of investing in a Fujifilm X-T4 for vlogging, but the announced features of the Fujifilm XS10 really got me thinking. So for today's video, I just wanted to do a quick discussion about the pros and cons of the Fujifilm XS10 and how it compares to the Fujifilm X-T4. Note that I will be discussing these cameras from the perspective of a vlogger, from the perspective of a filmmaker, so keep that in mind. Firstly, ergonomics. The Fujifilm XS10 looks to have a smaller body compared to the X-T4, which looks to be a better match for my style of video taking, more of run and gun, one-handed shooting. So in this regard, I think the Fujifilm XS10 is better for my needs. Next up is weather resistance. The Fujifilm XS10 does not come with weather resistance, and the Fujifilm X-T4 does come with weather resistance. Whether this will come into play or not, I will have to see, but I'm thinking, since I don't really like to shoot in the rain, that the Fujifilm XS10 would be enough for my needs. Next is battery. Now, the battery is really important for me. The Fujifilm X-T4 uses a brand new battery which should last about twice as long as the battery that comes with the Fujifilm XS10. The XS10 comes with the older style batteries which most other Fujifilm camera bodies use. Now, if you're a longtime Fujifilm shooter, you should already have a lot of these kinds of batteries. I myself have 4. But if I do choose the Fujifilm X-T4 and I won't be able to exchange batteries between my cameras because they would not be compatible. But I think for videographers and vloggers, this is more of a personal preference. It's really about if you want a bigger battery or if you're fine with just using your old batteries and switching them out whenever they run out. Next up is the internal stabilizer, or IBIS. I think IBIS is really important for my style of shooting, which is more of quick draw shooting style when you really have to be ready to shoot at any moment. Both cameras should be okay for this style of shooting because both cameras have internal stabilization. Next up, shooting resolution. Both cameras can shoot at 1080p with an amazing 240 frames per second frame rate. The main difference between the frame rates here are when it comes to 4K. The Fujifilm X-T4 can shoot 4K at 60 frames per second, while the XS10 can only shoot at 30 frames per second. Now, this should not be too much of a problem if you primarily shoot in 24 frames per second, but for those really nice shots where you want to do a bit of slow-mo, you may consider the X-T4, but it is still more on personal preference, and it still mainly boils down to this final point. Final point is price. The Fujifilm X-T4 goes for around $1,700, while the Fujifilm XS10 only goes for around $1,000. Now, this is still $700, so it's really up to the buyer of the camera if this $700 is worth upgrading to the X-T4 from the XS10, or if the savings is enough to not have some of the more high-end features like weather resistance and the higher frame rate 4K video capture. For people going for the XS10 over the X-T4, that $700 can actually go into other equipment such as lighting, maybe a new drone, better microphones. So I guess it really just depends on the buyer. For me, I think I will be getting the Fujifilm XS10 just because as a starting out YouTuber, I think I wouldn't need the more premium features of the X-T4, and the extra money could go into better equipment, better lighting, maybe tripods, maybe even a drone. A drone would be amazing. I'd love to have aerial shots in my vlogs. But let me know what you think. Leave a comment down below if you think the XS10 is a lot better value than the X-T4. Please do point out anything that I may have missed regarding the features of the X-T4. If you are interested in seeing what I will be going for, it's probably going to be the XS10. If you want to see sample footage of the XS10, consider subscribing. I will definitely be doing reviews about that camera when I get it. That's it for now. I hope my opinions about these cameras help you in your decision in buying your own Fujifilm camera. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.